بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our lecture will be about the cell physiology. Our objective is to describe various parts of the cell, which are the cell membrane and cytoplasm, nucleus, and or cytoplasmic organelles. And we will describe to the function of each one of them. Also the subcellular organelles and their function. Starting with the cell. Cell is the basic living unit for structure and function of the body. More than 100 trillion cells in the body. They are very small in size, bounded by the cell membrane, which will we discuss, come to discuss first, responsible for maintaining homeostasis of the inside of the interior of the cell. It's also cell contain various membrane bound compartments and organelles in the cytoplasm. Three principal parts of the cell. It's the cell membrane and the cytoplasm and the nucleus, and inside it the nucleolus. The plasma membrane. It is composed of double layer of phospholipid with hydrophobic and hydrophilic parts, and we'll come to them. Proteins span or partial span, يعني تخترق بشكل كامل أو بشكل جزئي مغروزة في داخل الممبرين، إما تخترق بشكل كامل أو بشكل جزئي، وهذا أيضا راح نجي عليها الانتجرال ممبرين بروتينز. Outside negatively charged carbohydrates attach to the outer surface. هاي الكربوهيدرات مسؤولة عن إعطاء الشحنة السالبة للأوتسايد أوف ذا سيل، للإكستيرير أوف ذا سيل، وهذا أيضا مسؤول أيضا للإنتراكشن with of cell to cell interaction. This is the general structure. As we said, it is a double layer of phospholipid. This is the hydrophilic end, which is the glycerol head. As you see, it is like a ball, like a glycerol head. This is the hydrophilic part. Okay, this is all the polar end. While these two fatty acid tails emerging from the ball are the hydrophobic parts, the two fatty acid tails, these are the hydrophobic or the nonpolar ends of the double layer phospholipid. What's here in blue color are the proteins, either transmembrane proteins, they completely span or partially span the membrane, and these are the carbohydrates, as we said, which are responsible for giving the negative charge. These small bluish dots represent the cholesterol, and will come the function to prevent the cell membrane to become solid at room temperature, so that it maintain the semi-solid or semi-fluid consistency of the cell membrane. Regarding the composition, protein at shekel 55%, lipids 41%, of with them, يعني 25% are phospholipids, cholesterol 12%, 4% glycolipids, carbohydrates compose 3%. اللي شفناها على outer surface of the cell. Coming to the cell function, first, maintenance of cell shape and structure. Second is the transport function by selective permeability. هل hydrophilic will hydrophobic parts of the double layer phospholipid تسوي خاصية نفوذية اختيارية selective permeability، فلذلك راح lipid soluble substances will cross easily while other will need to transporter or a carrier substance ناقل حتى يدخلها إلى داخل السيل. الثيرد intercellular communication involving signal transduction while intercellular adhesion ونجي أيضا intercellular communication gap junction وإلى آخره والدايركتد سيل موفمنت. سيل ممبرين فوسفوليبيدز. As we said, glycerol head that contain the phosphate group which is polar and hydrophobic, اللي هو مثل الطوبة ball like. These are small balls here, each one of them هو هذا الجليسرول هيد. These let's say red or يعني pinkish color ball. These are the polar hydrophobic. While the two fatty acid tails, these are inside nonpolar hydrophobic, they restrict the passage of water and water soluble ions. Cholesterol, we said these small small dots in blue, in deep blue, responsible for reduce membrane fluidity by reducing the phospholipid movement, also stops the membrane from being solid at room temperatures. Cell membrane proteins. First, integral proteins, internal or intrinsic protein, which penetrate the lipid bilayer, يعني تخترق lipid bilayer كلها, span the membrane, transport the proteins, they provide structural channels or pores, يعني يكون إما جزء من pore complex, يعني فد يوصل نقاط معينة أو certain ions إلى آخره. Second, peripheral protein, external or extrinsic protein, embedded on one side, usually on the external surface of the protein. These are carrier proteins, مسؤولة عن إدخال بعض المواد لداخل الخلية عن طريق البلازما ممبرين. Bind the substance to be transferred include hormone receptors and cell surface antigen. And also lipid anchors proteins which lie outside the lipid bilayer, but they are covalently linked to the lipid molecules within the bilayer. These are the integral proteins which completely span. These are the extrinsic partially span. Also there are some outside اللي هو covalently linked to the lipid bilayer. Properties of integral membrane proteins. Integral membrane proteins demonstrate asymmetrical orientation. They are amphipathic. Amphipathic means that have hydrophobic and hydrophilic region, both. If they span the membrane, known as transmembrane proteins. Functions of the cell membrane proteins, they provide structural support, also transport molecule, enzymatic control of the chemical reactions, some function as receptors for hormones, some function as regulatory molecule that arrives on the outer surface of the membrane, some act as antigen and induce the process of antibody formation. General function of the cell membrane carbohydrates, they attach cells to each other, act as a receptor substance, participate in the immune reactions, and give the overall negative charge which affect the interaction of the cell. Classification of cell membrane receptors, either ion channel, ionotropic receptors like GABA, acetylcholine, or catalytic receptor, or G protein coupled or G protein linked receptors.